workers, we don't consider factory workers, we consider them skilled artisans. If you were producing something in China, there's no doubt that the Chinese are super copyists, but what you get from the UK, we're a very craft-based nation, we can't help that. And the people that we've got working with us, many of whom have worked with us for over 20 years, have a skill that's inherent that they really don't even realise that they have. They have many recipes and specifications in their head, and it's second nature to them to produce artisan-type product.
My name is Samantha Hoy, but everybody calls me Sam. I'm the manager of the museum and development side for Proportion London. My inspiration basically came from when I was actually training in the special effects industry many moons ago, back in the 80s. They used lots of different techniques, and everybody there had something different to offer. So I've worked from everything from foaming latex to fiberglass to plasterwork to polystyrene.
I would say seeing the finished product, especially when it's come from a concept and it's been a work in progress over a few months, and that's gone into production. Seeing that finished article in the shop when it's covered and dressed up is quite rewarding. My name's Lee. I've been working for Proportion for the last 20 years now. I work in the paper mache department, and it's my job to oversee the work done in there, make sure it's done to a high standard. Some of the challenges come from the creative director. She'll come up with some wonderful ideas as concepts, and we have to somehow put them into production. The hardest part, I would say, is converting a concept into production. It's all very well spending 2 or 3 hours working on one piece, but if I have an order for 75, I won't be able to spend that long on it. The tailor's dummies are no longer just placed on stands. They're hung from the ceilings, they're placed on the side walls, they're placed in very strange places in the shop window. My wife often doesn't believe me when we're in the shops, because first of all I'll be looking at the mannequin and not the clothes. But she won't believe me when I say that these are from our place, these are from my room. But I just recognise them. The work is very distinctive that comes from here.
Online has come up a lot in the last few years, and I always get asked, is this the end of retail display? We don't think so, because shopping has now become a leisure pastime rather than a necessity. People can buy everything online, but bricks and mortar is still so important. It's where the theatre is created for a brand, and therefore what we do is, far from being a dying trade, has become even more important.